video number 13 for bass players. And in this video, we're going to be playing number 13 through 16 in your book. Before we do that, we're going to do some echoing. At some point, you're going to be very tempted to skip the echoing part of the video because, quite honestly, it's a little bit boring. But here's what's happening during this echoing. We are, again, developing habits, correct? We want to make sure they're good habits. I'm going to give you some kind of tips on making sure you're doing this, make sure your finger's doing this, make sure you're plucking here. You don't want to miss that. The other thing that's happening is you're building strength and agility. And if you will do all of these with me, when you get to the more complicated songs, you're going to learn them so much more quickly because you have developed that agility. The agility that we're looking for is moving quickly between different notes. So when we actually have to add the note reading part to it, you're able to do so because you already have that agility. Okay? So make sure you don't skip any of these. We're going to do some echoing. Just start with open D just to make sure that you are keeping a steady tempo. Get yourself warmed up. Four open Ds, echo me. One, two, three, four, go. D, 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 D. Now play open G. G, 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 G. Go. G, 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 G. If you have forgotten, the G is the skinny string. Now we're gonna put fingers down. Play four F sharps. Check your hand position. Your elbow is going to be slightly lower than your hand. Big space here. First finger's on the first fat tape. Second finger on the skinny silver. Third finger in between. And fourth finger on the second fat silver. Okay? Play four F sharps. And go. F sharp, F sharp, F sharp, F sharp. Now remember, if you don't have that strong posture, you don't have a hope of getting a good F sharp. You're going to get the thunky sound forever. If you can't reach around your bass, you're not going to be able to get that F sharp. Look how close the bass is to my face. That's where we want that, okay? So that we can reach around and use the weight of your arm to press the string down, not just your fingers. Don't let your fingers collapse down like this either. That's another common problem. If that happens, poke them back up. And remember, the part of the finger that we want touching the string, see where I have my lines. You can see them right there. I'm sure the indentations on 2, 3, and 4. That's where we want that, okay? Now I want you to hover with your fingers on the D string, touching the D string, but not pressed in, because you're gonna play two open Gs, and then you're gonna play two F sharp. See how I have open G, and then I have F sharp. Play that, open G, now F sharp. Go. G, G, press in, F sharp, F sharp. No, back and forth. G, F sharp, G, F sharp. Go. G, F sharp, G, F sharp. This back and forth stuff, that's part of the agility I was talking to about. Now, two F sharps, two E's. One finger for E. F sharp and E, F sharp, F sharp, E, E. Go. F sharp, E, E. Reverse E, then F sharp. Echo me. E. That elbow strong, go E, E, press in, F sharp, F sharp. Don't let them collapse. Okay, and from the camera, it looks like my pinky is all straightened. It's actually not. There's a curve in the pinky. You just can't see it. Coming straight on, the camera makes it look flat. It's really not. Now do E, F sharp, E, F sharp. Try that. E, F sharp, E, F sharp. Go. E, F sharp, E, F sharp. Now, I want you to look at number 13 in your book. And a good thing to do before you start any song, even these kind of easy ones, is to look at the whole thing and make sure there are no surprises. So I'm seeing this is going back and forth between G and F sharp. But the surprise in this one is the repeat sign. Don't forget the repeat sign. Let's try 13.
13.
Fingers are hovered, touching the D string, but not down. Red C, open G. G, G and F sharp. Press in, back to open G. See, I'm hovering, now I'm pressing in. G, hover, press in. F sharp, F sharp, G, F sharp, G, and repeat. Beginning, G, press in for F sharp. Open G, hover, now press in hard for F sharp. And hover, F sharp, press in hard. Hover, F sharp, G. Okay, now at this point, if you did not get 13 correct, please pause the video, practice it, Then rewind the video and try it again. Okay? Do it until you get it right. Now, looking at 14, we're going to look through it, but 14, yeah, I bet you could memorize that right now. You're like, oh, can't we just skip this? It's easy. No, because we're going to practice a couple things. First of all, one of the things we're doing is training our eyeballs to make sure they're following along in the music. That's one of the things we're doing. Something else is we're building strength here. We're also training ourselves to keep a very steady tempo, very steady beat. The other thing I want you doing while you're playing the E is have your other fingers hovered above so they look like they're going down. Don't get in the habit of doing this when you're playing E. Why? Because one day you want to play fast. You won't be able to if your fingers are out here. We need to train them to stay hovered above. But in this case, they're not actually going to touch the string. They're just going to be a little bit above the string. So number 14, let's read E.
14.
Go for perfection. Let's read E. Right on the tape. Fingers hovered above. Good posture. Strong posture. E, E, E. Be right with it. Don't be early or late. Most people tend to be a little too early. E, E, E. Okay? You probably did not miss notes, but feel free to try that one again if you feel like you need to. Now looking at number 15, I'm looking at this and going, this one looks pretty easy, but we have more notes. We have G, F sharp, and E. It doesn't go to D. This is where things can be confusing, because look, it goes G, G, F sharp, E, E. You're gonna expect that it's gonna go back down, all the way down to D, because it's just going down in order. Doesn't do that, does it? There's the trick right there. G, G, F sharp, E, E, F sharp. And then right after that, you have a rest. And right after that rest, you go back to E. E, E, F sharp, G, G, G. Measure three and four, pretty easy. Measure two, not so much. And two, getting into three, not so much. Watch your music and you will get it. Okay? So your G is your first note, but you're hovered and then press in when it's time. 15.
15. Walking song. We're
ready for your F sharp. F sharp's prepared. Two, red, say, and go. G. Now press in for F sharp. Now E. Now back to F sharp, back to E, F sharp, hover for the G, why? Because we're repeating, and I know I'm going to have to do F sharp again. Now, F sharp, keep those fingers right above the string, back to E, F sharp, now hover. Okay, you probably need to practice that one a little bit before you move on to number 16. Now, if you're looking at number 16, it says to do a writing exercise in the book. You may do that. I'm not going to make you do that. You can do that. But do notice that at the end of the song, you're going to have, if you draw it in, you're going to have a double bar, which means there's no repeat in this one. Okay? Now this one, I think, is pretty easy because look, it goes G, G, F sharp, E, E, D. And then it just goes back up. D, D, E, E, F sharp, G. No real surprises other than the rest at the end of measure two. Other than that, everything's in order. Down and up. This should be pretty easy. Let's try it. 16.
16.
Hover above.
Essential elements quiz. Complete the writing exercise.
Have your hand position such that your F sharp would be perfect if you were to press it down right now. Open G first. Go G. Now F sharp. Now E. Open D. Hover above. D. Now E on the tape. Now F sharp. And now hover. We're going to do that one again. I want you to start and end with hovering that F sharp. Red, say, and go. G, F sharp. Now E. Now look, as I pick them up, my fingers are right under the string. They're not flying out. F sharp. Hover. Okay? Practice that page until
17.
You get them all right.
Hopscotch.
And you can't get them wrong. And then you'll be ready to move on.